Whatever happened to predictability? The milkman, the paper boy, evening TV. Did I get delivered here? Somebody tell me, please. This old world confuses me.
This is Mr. Hershey, and I'm here to remind you to always return your shopping carts at Walmart. Bye.
Okay, Boomer.
Now over to Jamie with some more announcements.
Hey guys.
So we have the quote of the day for you,
which is, often when you think you're at the end of something,
you're at the beginning of something else.
By Fred Rogers.
So let's all just try and stay positive,
stay safe, and wash those hands for 20 seconds or more.
Now over to your weather report.
Good afternoon, CV, or good morning, or good evening, or good 3 a.m. because you know all of our sleep schedules are messed up. But I hope whenever and wherever you are watching this that you are safe and healthy. Okay, so the weather for today is going to be a high of 49 with a low of 34. It's going to be pretty windy. Looking towards the weekend, Saturday is going to be sunny and in the 50s, and then it's even warmer on Sunday. It's going to be a high of 60, but it's going to be cloudy. Then looking towards the week, Monday through Thursday is going to be pretty rainy, but it's going to be warm. I hope that the sun will shine through the rain sometimes, though. Have a great week, CV. I will see you next Friday. Now for the headline news.
Thanks, Weather Girl. The coronavirus outbreak has come out of nowhere and really put a wrench in the lives of everyone across the country. But it's often when we face this kind of difficulty that we get to witness the strength and love of humanity itself. Since most of the news just makes us want to change the channel, I want to share some of the little but huge ways people have made a difference in our world. First off, you might be seeing more and more people in your neighborhoods taking a walk. Well, plenty of people have been making the most of what they have and entertaining these walkers with a chalk drawing in the driveway.
We can all fall and hide under the pressure of what's going on and be afraid, or we can decide, all right, you know what, I can't control everything and this is what I can control.
Even though it is a small act, anything to bring a smile to people's faces in this uncertain time is an extremely valuable gift. Another way people have been spreading some cheer is through teddy bear challenges. Homes have set up teddy bears in their own windows for children and parents walking or driving by to find and count how many they see.
We went the first night and found like 20 something, I think now 21. Now we're up to like 112.
Many neighborhoods in our very own Lancaster County have participated in this unique way to spread a little bit of happiness. I'm Sophia Steed, reporting.
Now over to a message from Mr. Thornton.
Hello, CV High School, coming to you live from the principal's home office. Mr. Thornton here with a message for our CV Today show. Thank you, Mr. Thomas, and our TV studio students for continuing that great resource. We are here continuing to fight the COVID-19 virus, social distancing, washing our hands, making sure we don't touch our faces. Those are the simple things, but very important things we have to do, just like we have to continue our schoolwork and our school year. So this week we opened up the fourth marking period courses of your schedule and continued those courses of the second semester. And we need 100% participation from all students. We need to do that to determine credits. We need to determine whether it's going to count for graduation requirements. And really, it's because we all need to rise up at this very important time and show our very best. times of adversity, tough times. That's when we can discover things about ourselves we never knew before. So we're counting on you, and we're going to be continuing this type of work and this type of educational environment for the foreseeable future. So stay tuned for updates. We will certainly share those with you as we know them. And we're getting ready for the big weekend. This is our spring break weekend. For those celebrating Easter, happy Easter to you. No official school on Friday, April 10th, or Monday, April 13th. So we wish you all the best, and we have a short video to help you get some extra perspective and extra inspiration. And here it is now. Thank you.
Health workers diagnosed with the virus represent 14% of all those cases.
And unemployment claims are higher than they have ever been in our history.
Change the world, start off by making your bed. If you make your bed every morning, you will have accomplished the first task of the day. It will give you a small sense of pride, and it will encourage you to do another task, and another, and another. And a made bed gives you encouragement that tomorrow will be better. I've been a Navy SEAL for 36 years. Every morning, my instructors, who at the time were all Vietnam veterans, would show up in my barracks room. And the first thing they'd do was inspect my bed. The corners would be square, the covers would be pulled tight, the pillow centered just under the headboard, and the extra blanket folded neatly at the foot of the rack. It was a simple task, mundane at best, but every morning we were required to make our bed to perfection. It seemed a little ridiculous at the time, particularly in light of the fact that we were aspiring to be real warriors, tough, battle-hardened SEALs. But the wisdom of this simple act has been proven to me many times over. And by the end of the day, that one task completed will have turned into many tasks completed. Making your bed will also reinforce the fact that the little things in life matter. If you can't do the little things right, you'll never be able to do the big things right. Our struggles in this world are similar, and the lessons to overcome those struggles and to move forward, changing ourselves and changing the world around us, will apply equally to all. At times, it will test you to your very core. It will be painful. It will be discouraging. At that darkest moment of the mission is a time when you need to be calm, and your inner strength must be brought to bear. If you want to change the world, you must be your very best in the darkest moments. But changing the world can happen anywhere, and anyone can do it. If I have learned anything in my time traveling the world, it is the power of hope. The power of one person. One person can change the world by giving people hope. Start each day with a task completed. Find someone to help you through life. Respect everyone. Know that life is not fair and that you will fail often. But if you step up when the times are the toughest, lift up the downtrodden, and never, ever give up, if you do these things, the next generation and the generations that follow will live in a world far better than the one we have today. And what started here will indeed have changed the world for the better. But the question is, what will the world look like after you change it?
Now over to Money with Mead.
Money.
Hey, CV, this is Mrs. Mead with Money with Mead, and I am coming to you from my home. I am glad that Mr. Thomas has decided to try to do the TV studio at least once a week. So hello to everyone. Seniors, you've been trying to see me. At least I hope you've been seeing me. I've been posting it in our new Money with Mead Schoology page. I've also been trying to keep up with the class of 2020 Schoology page. So hopefully that's working well. But first off, I wanted to say to the 9th, 10th, and 11th graders, I am so sorry that a lot of the events that you have applied for have been canceled. But what I can say to you is no one can take that honor away from you. So make sure you understand that, and please make sure you always list them on your applications, whether it's for a job or schooling or anything in the near future. I'm so proud of you, and so is everybody here at CV. To parents and teachers, if you're watching, I want to give you a big kudos. I know how it is trying to manage, and especially if multiple children on these classes. I just want to say, if I had more money with Mead, I would try to organize something for parents and teachers. I just wanted to say thank you and keep up the great work. And if you need anything, let us know. I even know how frustrating it is to go to the grocery store. We should have an award for that. But anyway, now on to the 12th graders. Time is ticking, and I know this is crazy, but basically we only have 3 Fridays left, April 10th, which might be today, and April 17th and April 24th. And then believe it or not, we are meeting as the awards committee on April 29th still. So a lot of our applications need to be turned in on the due dates, and we are going to arrange the winners on the 29th, and also other winners are coming in from outside community sources. So I just wanted you to know that, and we are going to come up with some kind of senior awards night for you. We may not be able to gather into one place, but whether it's a video or a Zoom Skype or a Zoom session or something, we are going to make this possible for you because we can't take this away from you. We are so proud of you. So keep bringing in these applications. So due Friday, April 10th is the Carr Memorial. It's $1,000 for industrial arts. If you're going into the industrial arts, please make sure you apply by midnight. Fritz Memorial is for a $500 if you're going into education, and those are both memorials. Also, Friday, April 17th, we have 3 due on April 17th. That is the ACT Award. It's for authentic, caring, and trustworthy individuals in the senior class, and that is for $500 given to us by Kingsway Realty. Also, we have the Upper Leacock Nursing, if you're going into the nursing field, and also the Upper Leacock Gold Collar Award. Gold Collar fields is usually those going into like the HVAC, construction, nursing industries, those that we can't live without. Those are the ones that are still working today. Those are the few that are going into those. Make sure you apply because it's $1,000. Once again, I miss you guys. I hope that you are continuing to do this, and I hope to see you all very soon. This is Mrs. Mead with Money with Mead. Bye.
Now over to a quarantine segment.
It's Corona time. Hey, it's Corona time right now.
A.M.
It's Corona time. Hey.
Anyone want some cookies? Just need some brownies. Anyone want some? I have banana bread if anyone wants it.
It's Corona time. Hey.
Ellie, what are you doing?
I'm dyeing my hair pink.
Eventually.
Looks good, right?
It's Corona time. Hey.
Buddy, I figured it out. The reason that you are also stressed around me is that you are too intimidated to tell me what you really think.
It's Corona time. Hey. We'll be right back.
Now over to film talk.
How's it going, everybody? My name is Treyway Sandusky, and welcome to The Streamline. Each week, I will be coming in and giving you three high-quality quarantine streams for you guys, starting off on Amazon Prime. Clue, the 1985 board game adaptation. It's a mystery comedy, and it is so much funnier than I thought it would be. Now, I'd seen it before when I was a youngin' and forgot all about it because, one, I didn't own Clue, and two, I didn't care that much. But watching it again and seeing Tim Curry, the original Pennywise, it's honestly very entertaining. However, not the best board game movie. Let me count down the top five best board game movies for you. Number five, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. I don't remember Johnny Depp being a playable character in the Candyland board game, but we'll go with it. Number four, Battleship. Why? Number three, Michael Shannon. Honestly, the best board game. I remember playing him as a young boy. Number two is Clue, and number one, as we all know, Babe 2, Pig in the City. The next stream that I have for you guys is Devs on Hulu. It is a sci-fi mystery about a girl's boyfriend going missing and her having to investigate the developmental wing of the tech company she works for, all the while being interrupted by a tech CEO who is much more than he seems. Being played by Ron Swanson, who kind of looks like Homeless Chester from Fairly Odd Parents in this series. I've liked it so far, even though it has more unnecessary slow-mo than a Zack Snyder movie, but I like seeing the mystery unravel. I like seeing the characters just lose their minds. I love that. And speaking of losing my mind, the feature stream that I have for you guys this week is Tiger King. That's right, the buzz has entered our world. It is so stupid and so funny and so, like, crazy. There's so much unexpected murder, and I honestly love it. Okay, the Tiger King is a man named Joe Exotic who looks like, how do I put this? Imagine, we all know the cinematic masterpiece Tooth Fairy 2. Imagine Larry the Cable Guy's character if he didn't have any of the powers but still, like, stole children's teeth. That's what he looks like. He's got a blonde mullet, he's got, like, magenta tassels, he's got the whole bit. He runs one of the largest tiger parks, or did. He is currently serving 22 years in jail. You'll have to watch the series to know why. I don't want to spoil too much, but it's crazy. The series has more colorful characters wanting to kill each other than the trailer for Trolls World Tour. That's on Netflix. Please watch it. I mean, look, we're going to be doing this every week. You have all week to watch so many series, so many movies, and there's a lot in store. I'll have more streams for you next week. As the great Ben Franklin once said, I'm shocked it's over. Also, where's my key? I'm Tran Dresky, wearing a questionable amount of pants. See you later, CB.
Hey, what's up, CV? It's Karis, and welcome to part two of Streamline. Thank you, Trey, for your awesome descriptions of your top three, but now it's time for me to share mine. So, I know we've all watched The Office and Friends 100 million times, but it's time to say goodbye to those and say hello to new comedy that isn't mediocre. Anyways, the first stream that I have for you guys is from Amazon Prime. It's the Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. Now, this is quite popular among our older folks because it has a lot of intellectual humor, so if you don't laugh at the stupidity of teenagers, then because you're a comedic snob, then this one might be for you. If you actually enjoy stand-up comedy and thought-up comedy, then this one is also worthy of your watching. It is about a mother and a wife in the 1950s who discovers her talent for stand-up comedy. This follows her story from being a housewife to sitting on the couch of The Tonight Show. The next show I have for you guys is from Hulu. Now, Hulu is so behind in the streaming world. Most of their originals are not very good at all. However, there is one exception, The Handmaid's Tale. Now, if you haven't even heard of this, and where have you been for the past year? This is Emmy-winning, and it is so good. It is about a girl who is living as a handmaid in a dystopian society set in America. Now, handmaids are used to give birth for the wealthy because of their overwhelmingly low population. And this is so good. I would highly recommend if you have Hulu. And the last and feature for this week is from Netflix. Now, Trey stole my original feature from Right Under Me, and it was Tiger King. But I will reiterate, you definitely should watch it. It's so funny. But I have chosen a different film for the feature. Now, this isn't a TV show, but I still highly recommend that you watch it. It'll fill up a good 2.5 hours for you. It's In the Tall Grass by Stephen King. It is a Netflix original, but it was written by Stephen King, and let me say, he did not disappoint. It is so creepy, and it's so weird, and it'll mess with your head and keep you on your toes for the rest of quarantine. I really love this movie, and I would highly recommend it. It is about a maze that when people go in, they hardly ever get out. And they are stuck in a time warp, and there's different things that happen. It's just really cool, and it's so confusing, so I would highly recommend to keep you on your toes for this quarantine. But those are my top 3 streams for this week. So I'll see you next week, CV. Over and out.
Now over to viral video.
Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Bum, 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 bum. Make him the cutest that I've ever seen. Bum, 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 bum. Give him 2 lips like roses and clover. Bum, 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 bum. And tell him that his lonesome nights are.
And now, your viral video.
911, what's your emergency?
What? No puedo dejar de hablar español.
Oh, you're speaking Spanish. Okay, I took a little in high school, so I got you. You're good.
No, hablo español.
But you're hablaring español.
Can't stop pasando.
I think what is pasando is that you're speaking Spanish.
No, habla español.
Okay, let me get this straight. You're saying you don't speak Spanish, but right now you are speaking Spanish.
Pienso que sí. Esta mañana me golpeé la cabeza en la puerta.
You don't know you're speaking Spanish.
Sí.
And before you hit your head, you used to speak English.
Sí.
Maybe try hitting yourself in the head again.
Mi cabeza.
Your cabeza.
Carl.
So, are you okay?
You know, we had a little bit. Wait a minute. That's not me.
All right.
Now over to a student council video.
to Tea with CV.
Welcome to COVID-19 Vlog.
We're driving to Chick-fil-A.
Before we can anymore.
And Twin Valley, again, before we can anymore.
For like the third time this week, like what's going on with me?
But it's okay, because that's a good thing, because coffee is a good thing.
So Chick-fil-A first, see you there.
Figure out what I want, and what do you guys think? Should I get a large fry or a medium fry? I'm not gonna get a meal, because they're both cheaper if I just get...
Oh, there's somebody behind us. Okay, we need to order. Fries.
Oh shoot, okay.
Okay, we're ready.
Okay. Large fry.
Okay.
Plenty of Chick-fil-A sauce, please.
Mm-hmm. Could I have any of your order?
Bethany.
Aww.
Executive decision to go to the far away Twin Valley because it's the original. And we have all the time in the world, so why not? See you there, CV.
Hey!
That was your joke.
See you there, CV.
So we went to Twin Valley and we went to the long one, like you said.
Turn right on Willow Glen Road.
Freaking Siri, turn right onto something. And then we went all the way here. We got here and it's closed.
Yeah.
Corona closed my coffee stand. And I don't know why. Go to the
then turn left on Country
one
Lane.
That's by Shady Maple, the one that's closer to our house. We'll tuck in with you later. Say later, say bye.
We had a little detour. I accidentally clicked on Turkey Hill instead of Twin Valley. Extra half hour, but it's okay. We're here now. So we're gonna go get coffee.
And I think it just stopped raining. It's really sunny.
I think it did just stop raining.
Like I don't know how to feel because it looks nice out when it's raining and there's a deadly virus trying to kill us. And I keep burping because of my Chick-fil-A.
Thank you. That's where we are.
What are you doing?
My cousin.
Literally, Madeline's cousin, whatever her name is, gave me 4 stamps. We bought 2 toddies. She's literally the MVP.
Oh, I didn't mix it. Still good. What the heck? This is so good.
Sometimes I feel like throw my hands up in the air. Ooh. I know I can count on you. We are almost home. She's the wrong way. Mission accomplished. We got everything we wanted and more. We found friendship along the way and a sense of belonging that we just wouldn't have gotten if we stayed inside because of the coronavirus.
So basically, get out of your houses. No, I'm joking. Don't do that. Don't do that.
She's not joking.
No, I am joking.
See you next week, CV.
On coffee with Twin Valley.
Twin Valley. Twin Valley tea.
That's all the announcements we have for you today. On behalf of WCVH, I'm Madeline,
alongside Sophia,
and this is CV Today.